Tonight Your Side investigates the legal system when you've been ripped off and you think you've won your case.
You sue two contractors and the judge rules in your favor, ordering them to pay you back. Sounds pretty straightforward, right? Investigative reporter Chris Horn talked to a family who paid tens of thousands of dollars to renovate their home, but now they're left with nothing but a huge loan they have to repay.
No work, no materials. Their dream of a more comfortable home for their ailing grandmother squashed. That's what the Corbins of Newport News have gotten in return for paying nearly $30,000. They won a lawsuit, and one of the contractors even pleaded guilty to fraud. But the family is still waiting for any true sense of justice.
When we was almost at the point that the house was going to get started, you should have seen the excitement on her face.
Myra Corbin was so excited because she and her husband had just paid a contractor to expand and renovate their home. It's in Newport News. That was nearly 4 years ago.
And it was going to come out to about here. And that was going to be our master bedroom, which was, we're going to add a bathroom on the other side.
According to the Corbin's lawsuit, they dealt initially with this man, Jermaine Petty. It says at the last minute, Petty handed the project off to Roy Hodges of Hampton.
We had never met Mr. Roy Hodges until the day the signing of the contract.
They gave Hodges these two checks totaling $28,500 for materials to start the job. Corbin started checking the courthouse for permits.
I did that for approximately about 3 weeks. No permits have been pulled whatsoever.
Over the next few months, the Corbins say no materials ever arrived and no work was ever done.
The only work that they did do to our house is they put in the front of our house 7 stakes. That was it. Nothing else.
You just cannot imagine the hurt, the real hurt and disappointment when we thought we were actually moving forward with this project.
The Corbins sued. They were awarded not only their $28,500, but $60,000 more in punitive damages.
So they had won a judgment against Mr. Hodges.
The Corbins were happy. Back when they had signed the papers, they didn't have the $28,500 lying around. They had to take out a second mortgage. The payments, $417 a month. But their victory in court turned out to be hollow.
I was under the impression that when the judge gave us the decision with Ryan there, that they had to pay us restitution monthly.
On top of that, Hodges pleaded guilty in criminal court to construction fraud in 2014. The judge ordered Hodges to repay the money and then suspended a 5-year prison sentence. Surely the Corbins would get their money back now, but so far, payments have been slow and sporadic, a total of $3,800.
So you got less than $4,000 back and you were supposed to get at least the $28,500 back.
Absolutely, that was the order.
The Corbin's attorney in the civil case says a judgment is not nearly as clear cut as it sounds.
It is not, however, a mechanism by which the court reaches into the pockets of the defendant and then pulls out the money and hands it over to the plaintiffs.
So enforcing a judgment can take a long time and big bucks.
They're not easy. Oftentimes, we will collect on a civil judgment, and that process may take years, in some cases, probably decades.
The Corbins don't have that long. Myra's grandmother just turned 100. They were hoping to have more space so she'd be more comfortable. Hodges faces an upcoming hearing in criminal court for failing to make timely payments. That offers the Corbins some hope.
The restitution order, That's something by which the Commonwealth Attorney's Office can hold Mr. Hodges' feet to the flames.
Gave us their word that they was going to do the work for us.
We tried to reach Petty and Hodges in person and by phone. So the homeowners, just to recap, have a civil judgment against both men. The criminal case involves Hodges alone. At his hearing in April, the judge can bring his suspended sentence back into play if Hodges continues to fail to repay the Corbins. We'll follow up and let you know. Chris Horn, 10 on Your Side.